Good day and welcome back. In this video, we are going to enter new chapter about capacitor. So first, we look through the learning outcome. We will cover three topics today. So first, you should able to define capacitance, then able to describe the mechanism of the charging, use the formula to do the derivations of capacitance, and also about the dielectric, you should be able to define the relative permittivity, then the effect of the dielectric, and lastly about the formula of the capacitance. So first, look at the capacitor, which made of two parallel plates. So if you have a battery that connect to the capacitor, so what happened is that the electron will flow from the negative terminal of the battery to the plate. So the red plate here will be negatively charged and it will induce a positive charge on the blue plate. So the definitions of capacitance here is that it talks about the capability to store the charge. Our more specific definition is that it is the ratio of the charge on one of the plates to the potential difference between plates. So the formula of C is given as Q over next, we're going to move on to deeper into the parallel plates of the capacitors. So when the plates are charged, so you would have the electric field flowing from the positive plate to the negative plate. So as what we have learned in the last chapter, we talk about the Gauss law. So what we have from the Gauss law is the formula of EA equal to charge divided by the permittivity. So as E equal to V divided by D, so we rearrange the formula and you would get the formula of capacitance equal to the permittivity multiplied A divided by D. So from the formula we have, okay, so we can see that the capacitance of the capacitor is depending on the permittivity of the medium, area of the plate, and the distance between the plates. So in actual, it does not actually depends on the charge or the potential difference between the plates. Talking about dielectric, now we move on to the next topic. So the dielectric is an insulator that inserted between the plate, so such as the paper or the mica. So they do not conduct the electricity. However, when the capacitor is charged, we mentioned that the electric field is produced between the plates, and the electric field will polarize the molecule of the dielectric. So all the dielectric will align themselves based on their charge, where the positive end of the dielectric is attracted to the negative plate, and while the negative ends of dielectric will be facing the positive plate. So due to the positive and the negative end of the dielectric, so there is a reverse electric field, which is opposite to the electric field produced by the plates. And this would reduce the resultant electric field between the plates, which also reduce the resultant potential difference across the plate. But if we still connect the battery with the capacitor, so the capacitor will continue to charge until the resultant potential difference is equal to the electromotive force of the battery. So this is what happens when we charge the capacitor. Now we're going to do more analysis on the dielectric. So let's say we have an A capacitor with the area A and the distance D. So we say that the capacitance of the air capacitor is the epsilon naught multiplied A divided by D. So what happens when we have a dielectric between the plates is that we can calculate the capacitance using the same formula, that the permittivity is equal to the epsilon R multiplied epsilon naught, which we have discussed in the last chapter. So we substitute the formula of the C naught and you can get the formula of C equal to epsilon R multiplied C naught. And here you can see that the epsilon r also can be said as the dielectric constant, which can be defined as the ratio of the capacitance of the capacitor with the dielectric to the capacitance of a air capacitor with the same area and the same distance between the plate. Now we're going to look at these things in the graph. So we plot a graph of Q against the V. So for the air capacitor, Q equal to CV, which you can compare with the straight line, Y equal to MX. So for the air capacitor, Q equal to CV, So you have a straight line graph where the gradient of the graph is equal to the C naught. And as for the capacitor with the dielectric, such as the mica capacitor, so you would have a straight line graph which has a higher gradient since the epsilon r is more than 1. So from the graph here, we have two things can be discussed. So first, we can see that when the charge is conserved, mica capacitor has lower potential difference compared to the A capacitor. So this is because that there is a reverse electric field inside the plate, which reduces the potential difference between the plates. With the formula of C equal to Q over V, which represents the gradient of the graph. So it says that the mica capacitor has higher capacitance than the A capacitor. The second thing is that when we have the A capacitor and the mica capacitor are having the same potential difference, such as when they are equal to the EMF of the battery. So you can see that mica capacitor has more charge compared to the A capacitor, which we can go back to the first definitions of the capacitance, which describe the capability of a capacitor to store a charge. So in short, the dielectric can increase the capacitance of the capacitor, increase the amount of charge that can be stored inside the capacitor. So before we end the sessions, there's one question might be raised in these sessions, which what do you mean when the charge is conserved? So I can briefly tell you there are two cases when the charge is conserved. First thing is that when the capacitor is disconnected from any of the component, including the battery. Second thing is that when the potential difference between the capacitor has reached the same value as the EMF of the battery. So the charging process of the capacitor will be further discussed at the end of this chapter. So that's conclude my discussion for this video. So if you have any questions, you can leave it in the comment section below. And also please do leave a like and subscribe my channel. I see you in my next video. Thank you.